Greetings everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to see another interesting SQL question. So this time we are going to see how tax is cut for a particular employee based on the salaries. So you have a table where you have the columns employee ID, section 80C, section 80D, section 80G and total salary. And the output is you need to show employee ID, total salary and the total tax. So this is the output and this is the input. So now let's understand what is the logic, what are the rules that are to be followed to calculate the total tax that is to be paid. So these are the rules. So the section C, section 80C, that should be 1,50,000 or the value whichever is lower. Suppose if you have 1,80,000 section 80C, you will be deducted only 1,50,000 because that is the maximum limit. And similarly for 80D, 25,000 is the maximum limit and 80G does not have any limit. So this is the final whatever value you have in the table that will be considered, and standard deduction is 50,000. So this is the next income tax slabs, how much salary is cut based on the income tax slabs. Suppose if your salary is up to 2,50,000, then it is nil. And if it's a salary is from 2,50,000 to 5 lakhs, 5%. And if it's from 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs, it is 20%. And it's above 10 lakhs, it is 30%. So note, this is not the exact way to calculate calculate the income tax. But this just the purpose of this video is just to learn SQL, but not explaining you how to calculate the income tax that is cut. So this is just the basic rules. Okay. So and again, when I mention this income range, suppose if your salary is 12 lakhs, directly 30% of 12 lakhs is not cut. First, based on this income tax slabs, that is cut. So now let's see an example. Let's take an example and see how a particular tax is cut. So let's take this employee ID 10, who has a salary of 35 lakhs, and this is the 80C, 80D and 80G. So what is the final salary that is to be evaluated? Because we have all these deductions, so we need to deduct this from the total salary. So 35 lakhs minus 50,000, this is the standard deduction. And minus 1,50,000, which is the 80C, and minus 25,000, which is the 80D maximum limit. So even though you have 60,000 as the 80D value, only 25,000 is considered, and minus 35,000, which is 80G. And once you do the deductions, you have 32,40,000. So for this 32,40,000, income tax slab rates are applied. So now let's see how this slab rates are applied. So for 0 to 2,50,000, it is 0. For 2,50,000 to 5 lakhs, it is the difference is 2,50,000. And we have the 5% rule. So 5% of 2,50,000 is 12,500. And 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs, difference is 5 lakhs. And in that 5 lakhs, you have to deduct 20%. So that is, which is 1 lakh. And from 10 lakhs to this maximum 32,40,000, the difference is around 22,40,000. And that 22,40,000, if you apply 30%, which is 6,72,000. So the total salary, the total tax that this employee has to pay is 0 plus 12,500 plus 1 lakh plus 6,72,000, which is 7,84,500. So this is the total tax that the employee has to pay. So now let's see how to approach this using SQL. So now let's see the approach. So approach, we have to use the recursive CTE here. And we all know in the recursive CTE, you need an anchor query. So we have we'll write initially the query by updating the total salary. So whatever deductions we have done earlier, in the initial query, we'll do that deductions and assign that value as total salary. And we'll create a one more column called total tax, and we'll assign value 0. We'll keep it as the anchor query. And based on the anchor query, we'll update the total tax as per the slab rates or the percentages which are mentioned earlier. And for every computation, we'll decrease the total salary. So this third part, we'll see in the query which we will write. And based on that, you'll understand well how we are deducting the salary and how we are calculating the tax for each slabs. And recursive CTE needs to have a breaking condition. Somewhere the recursion should break. So the condition is if the total salary is less than or equal to 0. Because here you are deducting the salary after each tax computation. So somewhere the salary will become 0 after you deduct everything. So we'll break the CTE till the total salary is deducted to 0. So hope you all understood the rules. So now let's go back to SQL Server Studio and see how to solve this using SQL. So this is the input data which we are going to deal with. So we have this 10 employees data with the columns employee ID, ATC, section ATC, section ATD, section ATG, and the total salary. And these are the rules which we have discussed earlier. And this is the input data. Yeah. So now, as discussed, we'll use the recursive CTE. So first, in the recursive CTE, we'll have to write the anchor query. So as discussed, the anchor query is we need to compute the total salary after the deductions. So select from employee tax details, and here it is EMP underscore ID, comma. So section ATC. Suppose if the value is greater than or equal to 150,000, then we have to assign it 150,000. Else, whatever the value it is. So case when section ATC is greater than or equal to 150,000. So it's 150,000. Then 150,000. Else section ATC and as section ATC. Okay. So now ATC we have written the section ATC after the applying this rule. And now for next is section ATD. We'll just copy paste, and here if it is, we'll replace this with ATD, and ATD we are checking the limit as 25,000, right? So here we'll do 25,000, and here else it is ATD. And next is ATG. Section ATG is the same, whatever value we have. Okay. And then is the standard deduction. So standard deduction is the 50,000 we have to do. So now what we'll have to do, the total salary, what I'll do, total salary minus 50,000 minus this ATC. I'll apply this, I'll write this logic here, and again minus this ATD, whatever case statement we have written, we'll apply this, and here it is, again it is minus ATG. Okay. And end as, sorry, not end, just as total salary, total underscore salary. Okay. So now if we run this statement, let's see what we're getting. So for the first one, you have 1 lakh. Yeah. So let's compare the input. For the first row, you have the salary as 2,50,000, and you deduct all this section ATC, ATD and ATG. You deduct all this total from this total salary. You get this this is the final total salaries after the deduction. So now what I'll do, we'll keep this in a CTE. So with CTE as, okay. So this is the recursive part, and we have to do a union all select from CTE. Okay. So again, the employee ID is the same, and here we do not have much use with the section ATC, all these sections. So we'll just assign the same value, section ATG. So even if you do not use this columns also, it is fine. But I'm writing this so that you'll understand clearly what we are doing here. And here total salary. And one more thing we forgot. So we'll assign 0,0 as a total tax initially. Okay. So total tax will be a new column, which will assign the value 0. And here total salary will be, so case when total salary, so these rules we have to apply. So case when this total salary is greater than or equal to 10 lakhs, then what we'll have to do, total salary minus 10 lakhs. So, okay, first we'll try to calculate the total tax, then we'll deduct the total salaries. Okay. So total tax, how will we calculate? So initially we have kept it 0. So from this we'll add total tax plus, okay. So here what I'll do, case when total salary, this condition, total salary is greater than or equal to 10 lakhs, then total salary minus 10 lakhs. Total salary minus 10 lakhs, whatever is the value. For that value, we have to get 30%. So we'll multiply with 0.3. Okay. And again, when total salary after 10 lakhs, it is from 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs. So, after now it is greater than or equal to 5 lakhs. We have to achieve the total salary is greater than or equal to 5 lakhs. If it is greater than 5 or equal to 5 lakhs, then again total salary minus 5 lakhs. And here we have to multiply with 20%, 0.2. And again, when total underscore salary greater than or equal to 2.5 lakhs, 250123, then total salary minus 2,50,000. So here it is 5%, right? So here it is into 0.05. Okay, else zero, and here we'll end and add total tax. So in this way, so initially as discussed, right? So in the even in the earlier part of the video we have discussed. So for this 32,40,000, first we'll compute from 0 to 2,05,000, then from 2,05,000 to 2,50,000 to 5 lakhs, and then 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs, and then from 10 lakhs to whatever is the maximum salary. Okay, so that is the same logic I have applied here, but here we know in the case statement when we write in the particular order, the priority logic always comes, right? So if your salary is say 32 lakhs, I mean the final salary is say 32,40,000. So first if you write, first if you write total salary greater than 2,50,000, it will match, the condition will match, but that is not what we are looking for, right? Because if the, in these three conditions, if it is the maximum, if it is crossing 10,000, so this is the first condition that has to be evaluated, and then this condition, and then this condition. Okay, so this is the priority logic which you have to write. Okay, so first what we'll do, once the first for this 32,40,000, I am calculating the 30% range. So here I am trying, if this condition will be executed first, I am calculating the 30% range. So after I have calculated this 30% range, what I'll do, I'll deduct the salary by 10 lakh. If total salary is greater than or equal to 10,000, so whatever is the salary that is greater than or equal to 10,000, I have calculated the tax for it, right? So now I'll just round it to 10 lakhs. So because whatever amount is excess to 10,000, I have already calculated the salary. So that's why I have reduced the salary to 10 lakhs. Okay, and again, once you reduce it to 10 lakhs, I think here it is not greater than or equal to, we'll write greater than condition. Okay, once I have reduced it to 10 lakhs, this condition will not follow, then this condition will follow, right? So here this condition will pass, and this again total, again your tax computation will be done for 10 lakhs. Once this is done, so now total, so now here also it is greater than, not greater than or equal to. So again, after you calculate this 10 lakhs, then you are calculating it for the 5 lakhs. So once you have calculated 5 lakhs, you will reduce the salary to 5 lakhs. And again, you will reduce the salary to 2.5 lakhs. Else 0. End as total underscore tax. Okay. So in this way, we have to reduce the salary from the maximum, that is the 32,40,000 to 0. So in that way, we will be calculating the total tax. Okay. So now we have written this condition, and we need to break the CT somewhere, right? Let's see if all the columns are matching. So employee ID is there, ATC, ATD and ATG are there. Next, the total salary is there. I think here it is total salary, total underscore salary. Okay. And then the total tax we are calculating. Okay. And if we do not write a break condition, this is always execute, right? So where the total salary is, where the total salary is greater than zero. Suppose if the salary has become zero, I mean after reduction all this, if it becomes zero, then no need to calculate, right? So we'll break the condition CTE here, and I'll close the CTE, and we'll write select star from CTE. So let's see what we are getting from this recursive CTE now. So incorrect syntax near from, okay, something is missing here. This bracket is extra, I guess. Okay, so now let's run and see. types do not match between the anchor and recursive part in column total text. Okay, so total text, for some reason I kept it as 0, and here I am calculating 0 plus, but some reason it is not matching. So what I'll do, I'll use the cast, I'll assign this as decimal. So I'm doing this just so that the so that the type matches between both the queries. Okay, and so even I don't know why it is this is not passing, but I am for our purpose we are changing the data type of this particular column to decimal. Okay, and now if I run, let's see what we are getting. Okay, so if you see, for employee 1 you are getting 0 text. Okay, let's order by employee id, order by id 1. Okay, emp underscore id. Okay, so now if I run this, for employee id 1, since the total salary after deduction is 75,000, right? So for 75,000 you do not pay anything, so it is 0. Fine. For employee id 2, again after deduction the total salary, total salary is 65,000, again not required. For employee 3, 180,000, so not required. Employee id 4, after deduction it is 250,000. So 250,000 is required because we have written the greater than condition. So I mean, sorry, after employee 4, after deduction is 297,000. So for 297,000 it is required. So whatever is the difference between 250,000 and 297,000, 5% of that value is cut, that is 2350. So in this way, for each and every employee ID you are getting multiple rows here. Okay, so you need to see whatever is the so here you have multiple rows. Okay, but if you see the final tax value is assigned when the total salary here it is 0. Okay, so for the employee, when the employee ID is total salary is 0, that is the final tax value which is used, cut. So what I'll do, in the city I'll use where total underscore salary is equal to 0. So when I write this condition, it will filter out only, it will show only one row for all the employees. Okay, here, and I'll use the order by one, order by one. So in this way, now my total tax for each employee is cut shown. So if you remember earlier, for the ID we have seen, for the employee ID 10, the total salary is receiving 35 lakhs, but after our calculations it is 7,84,500. So in this way we'll have to cut calculate the total tax. So anchor part is main, and this case statement, how to write the case statement and how to understand the priority logic is important. So hope you all like this question and this concept. So this is a day-to-day scenario which we all see, the total tax, but no one understands, most of the people do not understand how it is cut. So I just created a video using SQL to help people understand how a tax is cut. Although this is not 100%, the rules are not 100% correct, still there are a lot of rules, but for our purpose to learn SQL, this is what I have done. So hope you all like this video and the concept behind it. So if you have liked it, please click on the like button, and if you are new to my channel, please click on subscribe button, because once every 2-3 days I'm releasing a new video, and it will be helpful for you to learn SQL. So thank you, have a nice day.